Hello everyone and welcome back to The Great War, a mod for Napoleon Total War, and we are playing as Romania. My name is Ben Pope. Let me fix my mic a little bit, they might squeak. Was that squeaky? Hopefully not. Alright, last time we took Istanbul, and that was fun. Our army is here. We can't fix anything because we're not making money. I'm gonna go through the what could happen here while I end this turn. So we need some money to fix this stuff. That's 240. This is 602, and I believe this is fine. These are also broken, but we don't really have to worry about those. There's some Austrian troops coming our way. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I've tried to record this episode once before, and there's quite a lot more troops coming from the Transylvania region, from through the mountains rather, that are Austrian and not friendly. And I'm not gonna spoil how that's gonna go down, but pretty much I end up getting my butt kicked. So I'm doing this again, and I wanted to tell you guys that, just so you kind of anticipate this is gonna be pretty weird. So what happens is we do have a trade agreement placed in with the major nations of France, United Kingdom, Russia, because they're neighbors, and Italy. The three that are via the water here will most likely, if they do the same thing, these Ottoman navy boats will likely, I forget the word now, the blockade, that's what it is, it's blockade. They're gonna blockade the port, so I won't be able to trade, and I won't make any of that money, so I'm still gonna be bankrupt. What I haven't done last time is, technology-wise, I'm trying to find out how I can build, ports that allows me to get ships, and I don't know. I really don't know. I'm guessing I'll have to change this out. I can't even do that. So, long story short, I can't get any navy units of my own. I don't think it's the super... Well, no, we'll leave that on the mortars. I don't think it's a super dreadnought thing, because that just lowers the upkeep cost. So something else here is supposed to give me access to boats, or have a total different type of building here instead of the massive industrial seaport, which I don't really want to take away because that's a lot of wealth to the region. So I'm gonna stop mumbling with that. Let's look at the government again. Policies. The Romania region is also very upset at me. I could exempt them from tax, which helps a little bit, but either way, we're gonna have rebellions here. So we're just gonna go on with that. Yeah, I don't know. I think I'm just gonna end the turn. I could, with the two units I have here, I could fight those guys. But I'm just gonna end the turn for now and take it all in stride to see what happens as we wait for France to do their thing. Those Austrians moved closer to where my farm is. I don't really want them to take out my farm, so I probably will attack them next turn with the people I have here. Just to have that food come in some more. I'm not gonna be starved out. Yeah, come on France, let's do it. So I do thank you for tuning in, guys. This is a very exciting series for me because I'm trying to relive history a little bit, you know. I mean, as with all the other Total War games, it's extra special when you play or view action from your own nation, and that's kind of why I really wanted to do this. And it's not easy at all with how this is set up. historically, Romania didn't do a whole lot in the beginning when they entered the war, and only later where when the tides were starting to turn in the favor of the Allies, they then joined the war and were able to attack the Austrians to take Transylvania, and there wasn't much resistance by then. Okay, so somebody has been recruited as an agent, and I believe that's Mr. Valery something or other. And which town do I want to put him in? Sophia's about done with their research. I could put them here. I could put him here and then do something else. Probably get snipers or something like that. So let's put him in here. It's not gonna speed this up very much or at all because it's just one turn left anyway. But I'm anticipating for the next one. The other thing I'm researching would be nice. Where is it? Mobilization. It'll give me a lot of other things. But it's gonna take a while to do that anyway. So workers are on strike. Over here somewhere, we don't have an actual revolution revolt yet, but there's the port blockaded, which means I didn't get that trade money. I did get 638 letter of demands to improve things over. Somebody gained a trade, and then port blockaded, and okay. All right, can I improve this at all as far as public order? If I do exempt them from tax this time, I probably won't make any money. I'll lose all that money that I made. But with the money that I made, I could repair this, which will give me that public order possibly. So let's repair that. We'll spend that money. And not tax these guys for a couple of turns should even out the odds. If I do tax them, I'll make 585, but it'll make them slightly more upset. And come to think of it, I probably can use that 585. And recruit some units, but if I can avoid rebellions, that would be better. So let's not tax him for one turn, see how that works. All right, I will go ahead and take these guys and attack these guys. They have a few extra people than I do, but I should be able to outmaneuver them and get my two units to attack one of their unit, focus fire that way and break them down before they break me down. That's kind of the idea. I want to keep that farm from being raided just a few bits longer, a few minutes longer. Okay, so they are down there. I believe I would want to maybe go and sort of see how that works. We want to be able to get on this hill, maybe. They're gonna probably go for a hilltop themselves. So let's speed up the movement here. Gonna get in range just a little bit. Hit play. Make sure they strike. Come on, come on, come on. Run faster, boys. Are you hitting in the hill or slightly? These guys are protected by that hill, so that's good. I'm just gonna fire from here. Should be able to see them drop. The problem is I'm kind of shooting uphill. That's my issue here. They're shooting at my other line. They're looking like they want to flank me. But they're not doing it, so let's move. Firing in the hill, really. Get in position, do it, come on, fire. Well, this group of soldiers are broken, so definitely had the advantage. We're gonna speed up a little bit because we don't want to sit here too long. We're gonna move these guys over here really quick. Move these guys down. Looks like they're all running, so let's see if we can catch them. They're all running to run away. Not gonna catch them, they're not gonna stop, are they? Well, that's one victory. Could have gone better, I could have gotten more of them. But I only lost very few units. There you go. Heroic victory. I think I only lost like 6 guys. Maybe not. Maybe 59. Apparently. Okay, we're gonna auto-resolve that. Apparently we have to say it in Russian. I'm not sure why. Okay. The view just screamed at me and went up high. Alright, so that's gonna repair. And we're gonna be in bankruptcy as we end the turn. That's fine. Let's get going. There's the first stack of Austrians. That's coming our way, as you can see. Good fun indeed. The reason I told you that I tried this before is because I'm gonna try a different strategy, and the strategy now that I'm trying is fall back. Before, I tried to take all my forces and fight the Austrians up there, which made it so there were rebellions in Istanbul, which I couldn't fight back anymore because my troops weren't there, and they just took. Ooh, this man has been recruited by a nation, isn't he? Okay, where is he? Another dude! Oh, look at that. I could put him in here, maybe. What do you do? He's sickly. Yes. Alright, well, hopefully you get better, mister. Let's see, workers riot. They damaged something, but population should be happier now. Oh, they damaged this. Bollocks. Which of course is gonna take like 8,000 to fix. Yeah, all right. So that research is out. I don't know if I need that right now since I cannot do. Diesel engines. Maybe I'll get this. Maybe I can do. Maybe I can get spawn bomber planes, spawns fighter planes. Maybe I'll leave this go. Maybe I'll let this go. Maybe that'll actually get me units. I just don't know. I tried to find out online, but that didn't work. Alright, mister, so you're gonna go that way, but not be able to do much. Maybe I can use you to do something else. What I'm gonna do with these guys is... Can I even exit from there? No. Alright, so workers' riot, letter of demand, that I'm bankrupt, and something... Technological advance, I closed it. Alright. Army got bombed, so that unit can't move because they got bombed. Apparently by bombers from airplanes or something. Okay, and the recruitment. Okay, so... Let's see, government. Will this improve? Likely not. It'll still go and get worse. Cultural differences. If I get taxes from them, I'll make some money. Looks like I still have to fight some rebellions. That's not gonna help. They're still angry. But the ruling class is indifferent. Is this gonna get better? You think? Let's not tax him one more time. Let's not tax him one more time. We're bankrupt anyway. If we can get these units replenished, which we might be able to. I don't even know how many. Okay, there's 137 of them right now. That's how that works. Okay, so. I was saying before with the with what I had to do is I tried to fight these guys back and they couldn't, so I lost this, but then at the same time I lost this because of rebellions. So it was like game over. Now I'm gonna try to pretty much not stay there. And if I have to give up Bucharest, I think it'll just have to happen, because, alright, so I have an option to intercept, but I can't. I don't think I can do much with two units against all those guys. they're all equal or better than my two troops. So we're going to decline attack, and they're going to go attack me there, and I'm going to have to retreat. And let's see. Okay. Well, that might buy me some time. I actually was able to retreat out of the farm. They didn't destroy the farm, so that's good. I wish the Russians would send help, since they're close by. You can't really ask them to send help. Even in the new... Total War games, you kind of can set a war target, but the AI doesn't really go and follow through. They'll send troops and then change their mind. And rarely I've seen in the playthroughs that I had, where I played through the campaign, where the AI actually goes and fights something you tell it to. Sometimes you do it, but you know, it's kind of rare. So again, guys, France taking forever. I think that's the motto of their campaign, and we probably should keep that in mind and make fun of them every time. Come on, guys, it's not that hard. Really isn't. If all goes well, even if I lose Bucharest right now, I'm hoping that they won't attack me at Romania, at Istanbul, which in that case I can move. I can build up and move and take the town back, take the region back, and also perhaps go against the Ottomans in Greece, because they're there. So the enemy has captured the settlement, occupied the area, and damaged the building. So they did damage the building. There's a rebellion in Romania. So there's the first of two rebellions, which I have to fight. This would cost a lot to fix. Okay, so apparently there's two rebellion rebel armies. Gonna have to take on both of them if possible. And we're gonna move these guys back. Can I fix this? What will this get me? Fuels. Does it do anything? Population growth. It might be better than not to get it repaired. But I can maybe train some guys. I can recruit. I can save my money and recruit some guys, because I don't think... Well, I say that, but I'm only making 300 because that farm is gone now. And if they attack the city, I won't make the 300 at all. So maybe I can get some... Maybe I can get some light infantry this time, and with the 300, can I get another howitzer or something? Oh, you know what? I'm gonna take the risk, and yeah, let's take the risk and not train anyone. I'm gonna take this army and attack these guys. It's a more threat. And we will have to fight this to make sure we do okay. I wonder if I can't move these guys to not reinforce. So those guys were reinforced, that's fine, let's fight. And once this fight is over, I have to move against the other, you know, small rebellion force that's down to the southwest a bit. And also possibly get back into town. And if I get back into town, that helps public order there, which means I should be better off. To avoid another rebellion later. Can I do that? Okay, so I have to make kind of unsure how to do it all, but we'll see. We'll put you guys up here. Unlimber. Let's take these four on this side, possibly have these guys in the center. Spread out, and you guys can support, I would say, over here. And who's left? Okay. Right. Okay, so before I get going, let's see what the terrain is like. I can maybe meet them over here, but they'll have the hill advantage. So I want to meet them fairly far out. Okay, well, let's see. Gonna put you guys over there. We're gonna put you guys over here. You guys can move up. And you guys can move up. And you guys move over here. I think you guys need to be over here. Alright, so our guns are firing. Have a couple of dudes coming in. Where are you guys? You guys are behind them? This is good. You guys can stay over here. That way. Yeah, that way if they run back, then you'll just get them. All right, sounds good. You guys moving fast? You are moving fast. All right. Let's move forward a bit. Forget that, I'm going over here with these guys. Come on, come on, come on. See some art, some fireworks. There we go. They're not really moving forward. They're pretty smart about it. So I'm gonna move forward and let's move up faster. You guys can take this spot, and you guys should be safe to move over here. Or not really. Stay there. Alright, everybody run, and we're gonna fast forward a bit. Okay, support this side. Bring this guy back here. Did I not grab you guys? No? Are you stuck? What's going on? Why can't you move?
Glorious victories, huh?
Ooh, they're all breaking. Come on. Forward, guys. Woods, come on. See them drop. There's one dropping. Alright, you guys should definitely move in here and speed up. Alright, come on. Forward. We're gonna catch any of these guys? I don't know if we are, but they're pretty much all gone. These guys firing anywhere? Not really. Okay, speed up. Oh no, they're running. Okay. Victory and battle. Heroic. Yes. So that rebellion should be dealt with. And this is actually gonna help us, I think. As far as public order, trait gain. The minister gained competence trait because it's gonna do that every time I zoom out, isn't it? After a fight. Alright, so can we go and attack them again? No. We should go in here. See what... not diplomatic. Should be a... bonus because I took down the rebellion, I think. But that's not happening. No? Okay, so... these guys can't go anywhere else anymore. Can you guys go in there? No. Alright, well, let's end turn one more time. That dude's making it to that town, which is useless now. That town is useless, I forgot about it. Alright, so they took my farm. The Austrians did. They haven't taken the city, which means that I can still make the money from the taxes there. Kinda sucks. I have abandoned Bucharest, I know, it's sad. And you're probably mad at me, but you know what? I really had to do it this way because I might get lucky that they won't take it from me and I can go back and fight back. But in the previous time I tried this, since I kept talking about it, I went in to defend Bucharest and more than one army came of the Austrians. So opportunity to intercept, yes, we're gonna auto resolve, that's good. Victory. That's what I wanted. They're gonna move and try to do something. Public servant dies. This man died. And who was that? Probably someone in the government. We don't know who he is, but we have some people that might be worth using. We have two tacticians. We already have a tactician. And we already have a navyman. Tacticianman. you're 27. Oh, the justice minister died. Morally impaired. Quite frankly, sir, I'm not sure why you took that job. Or who gave you that job. So he's competent with some trading expertise. He's got the harsh reputation, so we'll get rid of him. But of course now he seems to have gained some notably He's got 5 on justice. Is that going to help us? He's going to give us... Yeah, it's going to give us repression. And, too bad it makes the lower classes a bit sad. Alright, so then who do we get rid of to cycle through these guys? You probably won't need this trading expert. Honest and competent. The experienced men. It's just funny to say that way. Say something and men right after it, so it sounds like a name. Like, you know, competent men. Sounds like it could be a name. It could, I don't know. Honest men. It's funny. Anyway. Ooh, there it is. There's a second stack. Yeah. So. Who we? Let's get rid of these guys. Auto resolve. I think he said something about how unhappy he was that there was, you know, a rebellion. We will go and sit in the harbor with these guys. It's not going to do anything, but yeah. Research and technology. This will be done. We'll see what happens. Maybe, gosh, if I could just get rid of these guys from blockading my port. Okay, so I do have 800 big ones now. I can get a howitzer or a field gun. The range is bigger on the field guns, but the stats are pretty much the same. They have better melee defense on the howitzer. Accuracy is the same. What do I have currently? I think I have a light howitzer. So let's get a field gun. Let's get a field gun recruited. Our government is still making money, but I'm not going to make that money next time because of the tax. The tax is going to be gone if they do attack Bucharest there, which I'm sad. So there you have it. I think that's going to be it for today's episode. We fought some rebellions and... I think I got farther along than I did before trying to defend that land. The problem is, of course, that we likely lost our only source of food. Where's the food part? There's food shortage, some of it. There's food shortage, more of it there. Yeah, this doesn't make me much income, but it obviously makes enough that it keeps me in the green and not the red. So odds are that they'll try to take the city over, but it'll like just rebel on them. We'll see. We'll see how that works out. We're gonna end the episode here, guys. I really need to put these guys inside the city to replenish, because they're not replenishing at all outside, and I can't force march them at all. By the way, this says here that generals become available at a moderate rate, having this building. So I should be getting some generals soon. That's really good. That's really exciting for me. And there's all the stuff that I can recruit. And we'll be able to recruit later. Okay. Please do comment and let me know what you think. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this episode. Come back next time to see what happens next. It is a World War One scenario. It's a mod for Napoleon Total War. It's called The Great War. You can go ahead and download it if you want. I have the link to it in the description below. And we are trying to rewrite history for Romania, and that's the plan, and we shall stick to that and keep going. Hopefully I'll see you next time. Bye bye.